Welcome, everyone. My name is Matt Walter, and I'm a product manager for Google Analytics. Thanks for joining today's session so you can learn how to meet your business objectives with automation in Google Analytics 4.
And I'm Carly Boddy, and we're excited to share what we've been working on at this year's I.O.
We're going to start our journey today by talking about Google Analytics 4 properties and the key role automation plays in analytics, and then spend some time walking through a couple features we've been developing to help developers and marketers like you. Now let's dive in. Whether you're trying to turn your new game into the next global sensation, or your app is already one of the most successful in the App Store, Google Analytics helps all kinds of businesses better understand their users with automation. This means getting answers to your questions in Google Analytics so that you can meet your business objectives. For example, how are people discovering your app? Once they've downloaded it, what's keeping them engaged? Or where are they getting stuck? Today, we will show you how we're bringing Google's advanced automation technology to help you get useful insights across web and app and take action faster than ever before, so you can get answers to your questions even before you've asked them. For example, analytics can proactively notify you if a campaign is generating many sales. Machine learning can also help you predict which users will become customers in the near future and create an audience list for you to use in your acquisition campaigns. To bring this to life, let's take a look at what these new experiences actually look like using the Google Merchandise Store, which is a real e-commerce website that sells Google-branded merchandise and is available publicly as a Google Analytics demo account. Let's first look at the new Google Analytics homepage, which uses Google automation to help you complete the tasks you care about easier, faster, and better. The homepage surfaces information that's relevant to you based on your use of analytics, providing more personalized content in your property as you use the product. You can access the homepage by going to Home in the left navigation. Here is the new Google Analytics 4 homepage. One of the first things you'll see is the overview card, which shows metrics that are relevant to you with a trend line for each metric. If you regularly look at the total revenue metric, for example, Analytics adds a tab to the overview card with how much revenue changed in the last 7 days. This personalization helps you to see the metrics you care about the most, more easily and faster. The real-time card shows activity as it happens using data from the real-time report. For example, the card designed with privacy principles top of mind shows the number of users in the last 30 minutes with various countries from which the activity originates. This card is also personalized for you, which helps you see the info that matters the most to you faster and easier. The recently viewed section provides links to parts of an analytics account that you visited most recently. This saves you time by getting you back quickly to the work you were doing in your previous session. For example, if you recently viewed the BigQuery linking page in admin, the homepage includes a link to that specific admin page. The frequently viewed section shows cards that you view often. This acts as a bookmark and saves you extra clicks and time to get you back faster to the reports you value the most. For example, Analytics is displaying this user activity by cohort card, since I have regularly viewed this card in the past. Lastly, the Insights section shows unexpected changes, emerging trends, and other insights about your site and/or app. For example, here you can see there was an anomaly where there were more actual users than analytics had forecasted. Anomaly detection can help you more quickly identify changes in data that may warrant further analysis and action. By proactively surfacing these insights, we save you time and effort so you don't have to come up with these insights on your own. Now that you've seen how the new homepage works, I'm going to hand things off to Carly to show you how you can use predictive metrics in Google Analytics to meet your business objectives. Now over to you, Carly.
Businesses are always analyzing which marketing channels will help them acquire new customers and top spenders. With Google's machine learning models and analytics, analytics can analyze your data and predict future actions people may take. These models were developed in line with Google's AI principles and designed with privacy top of mind. Today, I'm excited to share with you the latest in predictive metrics and audiences in Google Analytics 4. Before, if you wanted to re-engage with users who were likely to purchase, you would make an audience of users that had abandoned items in their shopping cart in your merchandise store. However, you would have had to wait until a user actually met that criteria before you could re-engage them. Now, You can help connect customers with the products they want by enhancing your campaigns with predictive audiences. Google Analytics can forecast when a customer is likely to purchase and proactively surface that information to you via prediction-based insights cards. Let's take a look. In your Google Analytics 4 property, navigate to the Insights section from the homepage. Here, in the Insights section, Google Analytics will proactively and automatically surface insights with the power of predictive metrics and prompt you to build an audience off of them. In the Google Merchandise Store property, we see Analytics has identified users that are 7.6 times more likely to make a purchase than all users on the website. You can click the insight to instantly build an audience using the purchase probability metric. You'll be taken straight to the audience builder to create an audience of people who are likely to make a purchase in the next 7 days, which can then be used to reach users via a Google Ads campaign, for example. Purchase probability is just one of the predictive metrics that we offer in Google Analytics 4. Let's review the others that are available today. The second metric, churn probability, predicts how likely it is that recently active users will not visit your app or site in the next 7 days. You can build an audience using the churn probability metric to reach both likely 7-day churning users as well as 7-day churning purchasers, which is purchasers that are not likely to visit your app or website again in the next 7 days. You might reach out to a churning purchaser with an upcoming sale or a coupon code to encourage them to return to the site. Lastly, the predictive revenue metric predicts the revenue expected to come from all purchase conversions within the next 28 days. You can use this metric in an audience definition to reach the set of users that will drive the most revenue for your business over the next 28 days. Let's dive into a demo and see how we can leverage the power of these metrics within the Audience Builder. In Google Analytics 4, navigate to Configure, Audiences, New Audience. You'll see the predictive audience type under Suggested Audiences. In this section, you'll see all the options for audiences built using predictive metrics. Let's choose the predictive 28-day top spenders audience, which is an audience of users who are predicted to generate the most revenue in the next 28 days. Once you've selected the audience, you can additionally modify conditions built with predictive metrics, offering you even more flexibility to determine the percentile range within which users enter that audience. When you're modifying a condition built with a predictive metric, you now see an interactive graph that explains the trade-offs between prediction precision and the number of users that are included based on that predictive metric. For example, as you raise the lower bound of which users are included, a more precise prediction, you lower the number of users that can be included. You can also set the membership duration here on the right. Lastly, once saved, audiences are dynamically synced with Google Ads. As long as you have your project or property linked to Google Ads, these audiences will be available for simple activation to reach these users via your Google Ads campaigns. Today, Matt and I covered just a few of the latest enhancements in Google Analytics 4, including the new homepage, predictions insights cards, and a more powerful audience builder with predictive audiences. With these new tools and features available with Google Analytics 4, you have more automation than ever before to help you reach your business objectives. If you haven't already created and begun using a Google Analytics 4 property, get started today to take advantage of all the new and upcoming innovations in analytics. Thanks for watching!